In this video, we'll focus on select section order in the GMAT, something new that's been introduced in the GMAT since July 2017. What is it and what should you do presented with this on the day of the test? We'll look at both these parts in this video. Till the 10th of July 2017, whoever took the GMAT anywhere in the world had the test presented to them in a predetermined order. The sections appeared in only one way. The default way is you started with the AWA section, which is the essay, moved on to the integrated reasoning, and then took an optional 8-minute break, and then moved on to the quant section, took an optional 8-minute break, and wrapped the test with verbal. So this is how everyone took the test. What is wrong? What is right with it? Nothing wrong with it, except that for a lot of us, we ended up taking this verbal section in the last 75 minutes. By that time, we're completely tired mentally and physically, which probably explains why a lot of us have lesser score in the verbal section. What if we had the opportunity or were given an option to take the verbal section earlier on? That's what happens from the 11th of July. You have two more choices in addition to the default one. That is what is called the select section order. You can select the order in which you want to take the four sections. What are the two other options? Option two is basically this. You start with a verbal section, take an 8-minute break if you want to, and then move on to the quant section. Take an optional 8-minute break and wrap it with IR and AWA in that order. The third option that's presented to you is you start with the quant section, take an optional 8-minute break, move on to the verbal section, take an optional 8-minute break, and then wrap it with IR and AWA. Right? What does this basically do to us? This basically helps us prioritize the two sections which matter to us the most. Now, when do you make this choice? That's the most important question. This choice of selecting the order is made on the test day on the computer in which you're going to be taking the test and 2 minutes before you start the test. Before the first of the questions is shown to you, you'll have a screen that appears with these three options with the default one checked already. If you want to choose two or three, basically mark that on the radio button and then continue with the test. If you do nothing, the original default is how the test is going to be served to you. Now comes a crucial question. Which one should you select? Not selecting the default is a no-brainer, right? Basically, AWA and IR do not contribute to the so-called GMAT score that we are talking about. We all talk about GMAT score as 200 to 800. The quant and the verbal sections are the only two sections that are accounted for in the 200 to 800. So obviously, why waste the best energies that you have, the first 1 hour of the test time on AWA and IR? Leave it to the end. Start with a verbal or start with a quant? How do you choose that? Quite a lot of theories. One part is to say that I'm good at quant. See, I'm a quant trainer. I'm good at quant. So I might say that I can do the quant any time in the day. I'll be reasonably good at it. So let me get rid of the bugaboo that I have, which is the verbal section. So you could start with the verbal. If that is your weak area, move on to quant and wrap it with IR and AWA. There are others who will say that, let me start on a high note. I'm good at quant. So let me crack the quant section first and then move on to the verbal section and wrap it with IR and AWA. The choice to make is absolutely up to you, but I would recommend this. Take at least 4 tests. Take it from the same test preparation company. In fact, I'll go on to the extent of saying, take it from mba.com. 2 of these tests are free. Pay for 2 tests and take a total of 4 tests. Take 2 tests with verbal section as the first one. Take 2 tests with the quant section as the first one. Check out in which you score higher. The one you score higher is obviously what you're going to be selecting. At this point, I want to address one more myth most of us used to have, which is essentially, in the earlier default one, you finish the quant section and then you moved on to the verbal section. So people thought, we know that quant and verbal are adaptive tests. They always probably believed that how well you did your quant section is going to determine the level of difficulty of the verbal section. That was not true. That is still not true. Right? Whichever section you start and finish the test, the adaptiveness is restricted to that section. Quant is adaptive within quant. When you start the verbal section, the first question shown to any test taker is going to be a medium level difficulty question. So it does not carry over what you scored in one section to determine the level of difficulty of the question in the second one. We've desired, we've understood what this test select section order is. Second, we realized when it was being shown to us and when should we decide. We also have an idea as to how do we make this choice. Best wishes.